Alright. So, let's do this again, but I'm gonna try and concentrate on the napalm weapon. The laser is powerful, that is for sure. There we go. Level 2 is where this starts to become viable. It's a little rough up to that point. Firstly, find Aleste easy 1cc on normal. I plan to do 1cc on special difficulty, though. Basically the same as normal, I mean, with revenge bullets, right. Yeah, that's what I've been hearing, that it's a little bit more difficult because of the revenge bullets. You butt face. Wow. What a turd. Those things are nasty. I'll tell you what, the napalm in GGLS2 is definitely the bee's knees. Thank you. Looking at the trophies for this game, definitely some challenge in there. Yeah, I bet. Bonehead. The problem with this napalm is it's better when it's a spread weapon. When it's straight ahead, I like that it clears bullets, but it leaves you very vulnerable. Longer than I realized. I was not aware that it was 8 full stages. Oh, right into the bullet. Right in the face. Come on. Longer than your batteries. Touche, Duke Togo. No lies detected. Level 2 or level 3 with my napalm. I want to see, does it spread back out again, or what does it do once you get past level 3? I was trying to avoid those morons. Ah, come on. That is garbage. just rough. A couple of these spots are not easy. Oh, that sucked. Yeah, that sucked. Without the homing or other coverage, it definitely gets tricky in a couple of spots. Stupid early death. Did I just miss all of those? I would be curious to see this weapon at full power. Mm-hmm. Nice. Pretty good spread coverage there. Oh, this is at max, okay. Max wave is, Max wave is good. Squeak through there. Not bad. Hey, one more quarter. Happy New Year to you as well. Game on indeed. I got a clear on this with the homing weapon a little bit ago, and now I'm attempting it with this wave weapon. See what I can do. Should not have attempted to go into the fray like that. The slowdown is real. Well, that's helpful. Yes, it is an excellent collection of games. You are absolutely right. Yeah, well, I beat Blazing Chrome earlier on stream. I continued a bunch of times, so it wasn't a 1cc, but I'm probably not going to attempt to 1cc that game, because holy cow, my ability to execute cleanly with that is sorely lacking. Could turn off slowdown and flicker. Yeah, I know, but no, I want to play this as intended. At least in terms of slowdown and flicker. That might be an eventual goal. I'm trying to do a Dang it! Stupid friggin' enemies coming in from behind! Sucks! It's a terrible trope. Nice. Oh, gotcha, yeah. Yeah, I knew that, because I know people have done GGLS3 clears with the slowdown and flicker turned off. But I want to clear the game in the default manner first before I start looking at, you know, glory seeking. Frickin' sniper jerk. Wow, what a turd. Man, I get punked by those guys way more than I should. Stay long tonight. Best of luck to the ones. Thank you. Well, again, Happy New Year, and thanks for dropping in. Have yourself a good evening. Pretty powerful. I dig it. I like that it shows you when your next extend is based on the score. That is a handy feature. Ah, here we go. Bonus round. Thank you. Oh no! Okay. So 7 left to get to the next power up level. Yes! Okay, I got it. Nice! Speaking of M2, they're teaming up with Compile Heart with the new Shmup and the new IP. Yeah, I heard that. We mentioned that on the podcast, that Compile Heart had announced some titles, including a new Shmup. So that'll be cool to be able to, I don't know, to see what they do. How close that will be in spirit or in actuality to their old, you know, shoot 'em ups. Nice. Oh yeah, much better this go around. Yeah! Marvelous! Thank you. Nice. So I'm at shot level max. Totally maxed out on my shot and wave, so that's pretty sweet. Excellent. Boy, that's a heck of a bonus right there. 200,000 points? Holy cow. Yeah, giant bonus. I mean, comparatively with the rest of the score, it's a pretty hefty point bonus, so I would assume that from a scoring perspective, you really need to get a perfect on all of the bonus rounds, probably to truly max out your score. That's probably the biggest scoring strat in this game, other than collect power-ups and don't die. And shoot everything that moves. And also everything that doesn't. Dang it! What a turd burglar! That is annoying! time. I guess I probably could just use the wave. At the bottom of the screen. Get those guys who come up from the bottom. Yeah, just like that. So you're saying the little P icons give you no points, or all power-ups give you no points? Because that would be an interesting development. All power-ups, wow, okay. Huh. Curious. Nice. So realistically, it's enemy destruction and bonus round. Bonus round kills are what do it. Max score is no miss plus perfect bonus. Yup. Nice. Okay, well. Let's see if I can clear this game with 9 lives in stock. I'm definitely digging this wave weapon. This is legit. Yeah, so much easier once you know that those green orbs can be destroyed. Cool boss motif for sure. And a reasonably forgiving hitbox for a game of this type. To be perfectly honest. Nice. All right, space baby. Take you down. Heck yeah. Score here or what? 17 lives at the end. Nice! I wonder if the end game bonus was enough to earn me a couple of more extends. Kind of like Star Progier, how it does that. The bonus that you get from taking out the final boss is enough to add, I don't know, 3 or 5 lives or something goofy like that. Yeah, 1,373,330 points. That's probably my best score because I didn't get a perfect bonus on the previous run. Nice. That was good. So I now have beat the game with the homing weapon and the wave weapon. I like it. Cool. Well-made game for how simple it is. Agreed. Yeah, I mean, you gotta think, for 1991, for the time, for the hardware, this was pretty deluxe. I mean, because what was the competition in 1991? Holly Wars? Or, what was the other one? What's it called? I'm gonna forget what it's called now. I gotta look it up, because otherwise it'll bug me. I have a copy. I mean, Holly Wars is fine. Aerial Assault, that's what it was. Holly Wars was fine. You know, it was a decent interpretation of the arcade game for the hardware. Fantasy Zone Gear came out in 91 in Japan. Didn't release here until 92. But see, I don't think GG Aleste ever got a US release. Yeah, it was Japan only. Now, GGLS 2, or Power Strike 2, got a European release, and a Brazil release, and even a Korean release, it looks like. But, yeah, I mean, the only competition this game had in 91, really, was Fantasy Zone Gear. Or maybe Griffin, but